Shanghai GDG is a very interesting developer community.
I'm glad somebody has asked this question.
This is where the magic happens.
This is primarily a question and answer show. So if any of you out there would like to ask questions.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Google Developers Live. My name is Claudio, and this is Vic. We're two engineers in the Google Drive SDK team. Today, we're going to review an app that is on the Chrome Web Store and that integrates with Google Drive. We decided for today we wanted to show something that might be useful for students going back to school. So what is this app, Vic?
So the app is called Desmos Graphing Calculator. And it's a very popular app in the Chrome Web Store. I have their homepage open here, and we can just take a look through the core application. So essentially what it allows you to do is write a series of equations that come up with a graphical representation. So if we scroll down here, here's some recent graphs that people have made. Here's Batman. So somebody wrote some equations that created a bat signal.
How does it help with school?
Well, you know, learning must be fun, right?
Okay.
So if you create Batman, you'll probably learn a lot about these equations because these are not trivial equations. There's some other ones here that are a little bit more relevant. So here's a couple of waves and linear equations. So essentially, this application is targeted at anybody who needs to make graphs very often. Which I think is largely students working on classes. So this is an app that integrates with Google Drive via the Chrome Web Store. So to take a look today at this app and then review it, we're going to install it from the Chrome Web Store. So here I am in Drive, and I'm going to get more apps. And then when the Chrome Web Store comes up, we're going to see all of the Google Drive apps.
So when you click on Get More Apps, you're brought to a specific collection inside the Chrome Web Store where you can see all the applications that integrate with Drive.
Yeah, so there's a lot, but the one that we're looking for today is Desmos Graphing Calculator, which is right here. Mm-hmm. So if we click Add to Chrome, this is going to install it. Here we see that it came up in the Chrome New Tab page. Mm-hmm. I'm going to come back to Drive, and we'll be able to create more Graphing Calculator by Desmos. So if I create this, the first thing that we have to do is authorize the application and tell it that it can create graph files on our behalf and store them in Drive. So we're going to allow access. And then finally, we're taken into Desmos. So here, the graph is currently empty because we have no equations. But if I enter some equations, here, like here's one for a circle. It graphs instantly, and we can add more equations like x plus y equals 2 just for a line. So we could continue doing this and then save it to Desmos or to Drive. So here, if we click Save, it's asking us to create a new account or to log in.
This is a new account on Desmos, right?
Yeah.
It's not a Google account.
Yeah. The one difference is that we can sign in with OpenID on Google. Mm-hmm. And then you'll notice it asks us to authorize again. And we come back, and now we're actually saving the graph. So we'll say line and circle. Mm-hmm. And we'll just share it with the world for now and click Save Graph. So here we get a permalink and some ways to share it. Take me back to my graph. So One of the advantages of this application is that you can instantaneously graph pretty much any equation. Mm-hmm. It's very, very powerful for students.
And you can also start from someone else's graph.
Yeah.
And see
exactly
how that translates into equations. Maybe yep. This is very hard to understand, at least for me.
Yeah.
But you know, for some people, this can be very, very easy to understand. And you can easily move back and forth equation to graph.
Exactly.
Can you also edit it? Like,
yeah. So here, I could create a new expression on mm-hmm. this graph, and then you know, x squared plus mm-hmm. y squared.
So you can start from someone else's equation and extend it or change it. Or
yeah. So if we do that, then it really is good for collaboration between students and, mm-hmm. and teachers. So here, you know, maybe a teacher creates a template graph and then asks students to add some equations that will intersect certain points or, mm-hmm. or something like that. So super powerful app. There's also a keypad, and there's some other additional settings that you can do to customize the graphs. Like you can change like the labels on each of the axes and things like that. Mm-hmm. So we're very pleased with the core application. Mm-hmm. What we were going to talk about today is how they integrate with Drive and what they could do better or mm-hmm. what they already do well.
Okay.
So
I think we can start from the authorization mechanism.
Yeah. So when we when a user originates in Drive, they create more graphing calculator by mm-hmm. Desmos, right? One of the problems is that Desmos currently is not automatically logging the user in mm-hmm. When they originate from Drive. And this is a problem because it causes the user to have to log in twice. So here, actually, if I log out, we can demonstrate this a little bit more easily. Mm-hmm. So if I create another graph, the user should arrive at the application logged in, mm-hmm. but you can see that we're not logged in. So this is one convenience mechanism for users originating from Drive. Also, if the user originates from Drive, there's no way to actually save back to Drive at the moment. So I believe that this is something that Desmos used to support, mm-hmm. But removed temporarily because of some integration issues between Desmos and Google Drive. I think that those are issues we've since resolved. Mm-hmm. And so we're really looking forward to Desmos bringing this functionality back.
So what should be the best flow for the user?
Ideally, the best flow for the user is creating a graph from within Google Drive. Mm-hmm. And when they land here, they are logged in. Mm-hmm. And they create some graph, oops, mm-hmm. like this. And when they click Save, instead of requiring the user to log in again or create a Desmos account, mm-hmm. Instead of walking through this flow where I have to authorize a second time and then do this to save my graph, everything is saved into Drive automatically. Mm-hmm. So,
well, right now it's not.
Right. Right now, nothing has been saved into Drive. Mm-hmm. In fact, if we look at all of the files on this test account, we can see that there's just nothing here. Mm-hmm. So Desmos is saving the graph locally within Desmos. So their Drive integration is missing some key components right now, mm-hmm. Primarily the ability to create and store graphs within Drive. They're also missing the component to open certain graphing mm-hmm. files from within Drive, which is fine. But if they were storing native Desmos graphs in Drive, then those should be openable.
But they can also store some shortcuts to documents mm-hmm. stored on there.
Exactly.
On their server.
Yeah.
So maybe, and it depends on their implementation, but mm-hmm. one thing you can do as a developer is that you can still store all the data in your backend, whatever that is, a database, mm-hmm. a local file system, it doesn't matter. But you can have shortcuts, links, or pointers to those documents yeah. From Google Drive. Yeah. And this is not happening at the moment.
Yeah. That's exactly right. So it doesn't matter really if they store this data mm-hmm. in Drive or not. They could store it, on Desmos.com, but mm-hmm. link to it with a shortcut file from mm-hmm. within Drive. We need to make it clear though that Desmos is a perfect use case oh, yeah. for integrating like this with Google Drive. Here they have a single document interface mm-hmm. that's working on a single file at a time. And if that file was stored in Drive or a shortcut was stored in Drive, then it would add the ability for more users to interact with these things more quickly, mm-hmm. Which is pretty important. Mm-hmm. Also, integrating with Drive gets you things like sharing for free. It gets you searching for free and things like this. And it allows users to just collaborate on these documents a little bit mm-hmm. more quickly.
Yeah, there's also something else they can do to make the user experience better, integrating better with Google Drive. I see there's a button that says My Graphs on the top left yep. corner. What yep. does that do?
It shows all of your graphs saved in Desmos.
They can probably integrate this with Google Drive and show all the files you have, all
exactly.
the matching files you have on, yeah. on Google Drive.
Yeah.
And if developers want to integrate with, want to have a dialogue to pick mm-hmm. files from Drive, we provide that. It's called the Google Picker API. It's part of the Google Drive SDK. It's a JavaScript API you can use. You can easily integrate into your application and use it to show the list of files from the user's account that match some specific criteria.
Exactly. So if we go to the Drive SDK documentation at developers.google.com/drive, somewhere here, I think it's...
Manage Drive Files.
Yep. And then...
And
actually, no, I don't think it's there.
integrate with a Drive UI. Yeah.
Sorry, we just reworked this a little bit. So if we open files...
So there are different ways you can open files. The first one we saw is that you click on a file on the Drive UI, or you create a new one, and that saves it. But as I said, you can also use a picker.
Yeah. So here's the documentation about how to use the Google Drive picker, and essentially how to embed something contextually into the page of your application that will show essentially the Google Drive dialog box that allows you to choose files from within Google Drive. So you can see it's actually pretty quick and simple to implement. In Desmos' case, they may have a strong opinion that they want users only choosing files from within Desmos, and that's fine. Like a Drive SDK integration is not all or nothing. This is just another suggestion that would make their app easier to use from a Drive user's perspective. So.
And just to add something, while we mentioned the picker, the picker can be used to select files from Drive, but it can also be used to upload files from Drive. So let's say if you have a client-side application or you want the users to upload files, you can just use the same picker that you use for downloading to upload. Yeah. Maybe this is not the case for Desmos. I don't think they have to upload files to Drive, but it might be good to know.
Exactly, yeah. So, can you think of any other ways that Desmos could integrate with Drive?
I think the most confusing part is just the authentication and the login, the user creation, which is not clear for users what a Desmos account is and what a Google account is. And I mean, you think you're logged in into Google, and you are, and you're not logged into Desmos, or you can be logged into Desmos but not logged in into Google.
Yeah.
And this has to be as transparent as possible to the users so that they log in once, and that's it. And that's why we want developers to use OpenID, which is the technology that allow you to delegate authentication to Google.
Yeah. So other apps get around this in that if you know, for instance, another application needed to make a native account, they would automatically create the native account and associate the incoming Google user with that account. So when the user arrives from Drive, Drive also sends a token along, and the application should be using this token to, you know, to gain access to a user's Drive files when they arrive. Because the user, after they've installed the application and run it from within Drive, has already authorized the app to access certain files. So that could be a little bit cleaned up so that when I come here and I create more graphing calculator, I land here, I'm signed in, and when I save the file, it automatically goes back to Drive because that's where I originated from anyway.
And another suggestion I might have, it depends on what is the file format they use to store their data on Drive. So regardless if they have a shortcut to their document somewhere else, or if they store everything on Drive, this can probably be easily translated into some XML file or something like that, some kind of text files. Something they can do is to make it easier for Google to index the content, the text content, so that it can be easier for users to find a document.
Yeah.
So whenever you create an equation, when you save it, I think you can also add some description fields, some tags, or something like that.
If that is
a text file, then Google will automatically index that text so that users can find it by searching for some terms. But if that is a binary format, we don't have a way to find out what the text is. And they
Currently, within Desmos,
developers can provide some indexable text for us.
Exactly.
So there is this field in the API that they can use. So that even if we don't know what the file format is and we don't know how to open a specific file or read what the text content is, you can still provide us with some text content, and we will index it and treat it exactly the same way as we treat the text we index.
Yeah, exactly. So when creating or updating a file, applications can set the indexable text, mm-hmm. which is here. Mm-hmm. So like Claudio said, it's just a field of keywords, a normal text field, and you set whatever keywords you'd like Google to index on. And then when a user searches for something in Google Drive, if one of those keywords matches, then we show the file.
One of the things to mention about the indexable text field is that that field is write-only, mm-hmm. and you have to provide a new indexable text field every time you update the document. Because, of course, if you changed the content of your document, you have to change the indexable text accordingly.
Exactly.
And if you don't provide a new indexable text when you update an existing file, we will assume you just want to clear that field. So we will store an empty indexable text.
Yeah. So this is a feature request that we've gotten is to make the mm-hmm. indexable text readable by applications, and it's something we're considering. Mm-hmm. Getting back to Desmos, this is a really, really powerful application that we highly recommend you use. Go to the Chrome Web Store, install Desmos Graphing Calculator. It's very powerful. I actually use it somewhat often now that I've discovered it. It's very, very convenient for just drawing graphs of equations, mm-hmm. which we do often.
Just to before we wrap up, so you showed how to get to the Chrome Web Store when you start from Drive. Mm. And that is pretty easy. So you said you wanted to create something, you don't have an application, so you do more, and you get more apps.
Exactly.
And these will land you directly to the Drive application collection. What if you start from the web store directly? How do you find this collection inside Drive?
That's a good point.
The web store.
If we just land in the normal Chrome web store, this is mm-hmm. what it looks like. You can see various types of applications here. Mm-hmm. If you want to see all of the Google Drive applications, just go to Collections and then Google Drive. And then here you can see all of the apps that have some integration with Google Drive. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot. We recommend you just mm-hmm. take a look through them. There's a bunch of image editors, presentation editors. There's AutoCAD, WS, if you work with CAD documents.
To make it easy to recognize Google Drive applications, we added a small logo mm-hmm. to each listing. So that's this Google Drive logo on the bottom right corner. Yep. And if you click on on one of those listings, you will see that it works with Google Drive, which is our badge for it.
Exactly, yep.
And of course, you can as in all applications in the Chrome Web Store, you can read reviews from other users. Mm-hmm. You can see star rating and so on.
Yeah, so here's the listing for Desmos. You can see they have 142 five-star reviews. So if we go into the reviews, you can see, you know, this first review here from a Google user, nothing short of amazing, best thing out there. It's so good. I've never seen such a perfect graphing calculator.
Yeah, it's an amazing application.
Great application.
You should try it.
All right, so that about wraps it up for today's Google Developers Live. We reviewed Desmos Graphing Calculator.
Yeah, see you next week.
Yeah,
thank you very much.